I'm Laura Crossey, and I'm up here in the Valles Caldera on a July afternoon working on a joint project with the Valles Caldera National Preserve. Our team from the University of New Mexico is up here in the northern part of the Valles Caldera, which is situated in north central New Mexico. This is an example of the incredible field areas that we have accessible to not only train our students, but to actually develop some data sets that can be of great use to the citizens of New Mexico for water sustainability. We see this task as being within the large umbrella of activities that are looking at what New Mexico faces in terms of its water challenges. The Valles Caldera is an incredible hydrologic resource, a site of a relatively geologically recent volcanic eruption only a little over 1 million years ago. Still hosts an active geothermal system, but it also serves as a great watershed, supplying water down through these headwater regions where we're presently located, into the Jemez River, eventually into the Rio Grande, and recharging the northern part of the Albuquerque Basin aquifer system.
Well, as a grad student, I'm really interested in rivers and how they work geologically and hydrologically. And so this project is partly to help me learn those skills on how the water systems work hydrologically.
The key component of our project is actually monitoring water quality in the surface water systems of the Valles Caldera. Our specific cooperative agreement with the Valles Preserve involves deploying, calibrating, and downloading data sets from sensors that are situated within the streams. These sensors are individually really fantastic bundles of technology that sit and take readings every 15 minutes throughout the season, and that really helps us understand what's going on in the stream. If we use an analogy of a physician studying a human body, we're doing the same thing for the stream system to try to understand its health, its sustainability, how well it's able to work with the demands of the ecosystem up here, the elk, the higher parts of the food chain, the aquatic invertebrates, the plant life we see all around. It's all underpinned by water. So the water quality is extremely important, and it's important to maintain a baseline of measurements. So we're just, as I said, in year two of a 5-year program. And what we do is we come up every 3 weeks, we download our data, we make sure the sensors are working. There's a whole nother workload for us back at the lab as we curate these data sets and make sure that all the sensors are working properly. So here in New Mexico, we're really fortunate to be situated in so close, only an hour's drive away from a really incredible world-class field area. The Valles Caldera and its hydrologic system are a wonderful microcosm for the arid western United States and many other regions of the globe that are facing water scarcity or changes in water supply. So when our students come up here to work, they're getting experience in all the same parameters that they need to understand to take their work elsewhere.
The field experience is pretty spectacular. I think this is a wonderful location. It's a location that not everybody gets to come and work in. And that's sort of on a personal level, something I think that I will kind of take away as I move on to the next steps.
So it's a really good opportunity for me as an undergrad to look forward to graduate schools and be able to move forward with graduate programs, and influences my candidacy for getting a position as an undergrad doing research or doing something that I'm more likely to want to do.
When we start to think about New Mexico and the sustainable water supply, we start to think about a bigger time scale than an individual year. What's the snowpack like in 2019 compared to 2018, compared to 2017? What's it going to be like in 2023? These are the questions that we need to try to have a better answer to. And by consistent monitoring, that gives us a baseline against which to compare and to predict what's going to happen with future snowpacks.